Hello and welcome back to Flutter Networking. From good to start with Muhammad Fathi. This is our YouTube channel. You can go to the playlists. You will see all our videos here. Today I am going to talk about how to send the data to the server using the Chopper package. So this is the package. And you can get my source code here from the good to start. When you click on the go to the good to start, you can go to the repositories and you will see all our source code here. You can click, for example, on the this playlist, Flutter Networking and the API. You can go and download any lessons. For example, you can click on the lesson 5 and click on clone or download. So let me open the this is our aqueduct project running on the server. This is our Dart server running on the port 8080. So this is a port and this is running. You can get a list of authors and so let me open this project. So we have get a list of authors from the server and populate this list view and we can fetch an author by ID when you click on the any author. Today I am gonna create a new author. So let me go to the VS Code, and so this is a VS Code. Let me start with adding icon in the action. So this is scaffold. Here I am gonna add the action. So actually let me add icon here, icon, but so this will contain the icon. The icon will be of type icon icons dot add. And the on pressed, so this anonymous function. So here I am gonna navigate to the new screen to add a new author. So let me create the new screen or new page by click on the new file, and here I am gonna add a new screen called, for example, add underscore author dot dart, and this will let me first import material app. After that I am gonna create a stateful widget called add author, and inside this I am gonna return scaffold. So scaffold, so inside the scaffold I am gonna provide the app bar. So the app bar will be of type app bar widget. So inside the app bar I'm gonna provide the title. The title will be of type text, and here I'm gonna type, for example, a new author, and the body will be a column of type column. So the children, let me add text field. So this text field with a decoration will be of type input decoration. Here I'm gonna provide the hint text. The hint text will be, for example, author name, and I'm gonna duplicate this with the author bio, and here I'm gonna make this max line, provide the max line to make it multi line, for example 5. After that I'm gonna add a new text field for the age, so author age, and I'm gonna remove this max line. The last widget will be text. It will be about, so raised but. So the child will be text here, save or add, and the on pressed it will be anonymous function like this. So let me save this and go to the home. When you click on this add button, I'm gonna open the new screen by the routing navigator. dot push. So I am gonna go to bus the context, and here will be of type material page route. Will be material page route. So the builder, I'm gonna provide the builder, will be anonymous function that will take context, and it gonna return an instance of the add author. So like this, let me save, and when you open the emulator, now we have a button here. We can remove this banner. If you go to the main and here the debug, debug show checked mode banner equal to false. Try to save and open the emulator. Now we can add the click on the add button. It will be open new screen. We need to add a padding here. So let me go to the add author. You can, for example, in this column, try to padding. So we can wrap this with a padding here, padding, wrap with a widget or a padding, and this is fine. Let me save and open this. So now it's good. So let me when you add author and author bio and click add, I'm gonna send this data to the server. So and get back to the home screen to so this will list the all authors. So let me here add the code to get all the data and put it and send it to the server. So I'm gonna go in the add author, and inside this here I'm gonna declare attributes for the three text field. So the first one will be string name and the bio, and also we need the int age. So let me go for each of the text field, and here on change we will have a value. Here I'm gonna take this value and assign it to the name set state. So the name equal to the value, and also I'm gonna repeat this with the bio. So here inside the bio, and this will be the bio, and also I'm gonna repeat this with the age. But here the age we need to parse int dot parse. And now we have the data. So now when you click on this button, I am gonna call the author service. So author service, this is a author service from the network folder. We can create an author by call the first call the create method to get an instance of the author service. After that call the create author, and you need to pass to this method a map. So the map will contain a string and dynamic, the string key, and the dynamic will be the value. So let me go to the add author here, and first before call this, I'm gonna var declare an author. So this will be a map. So here the name, the author name, the name will be the key, the value will be the name to confirm the user, and the age will be the age, and the last one the bio will be the bio. So this is an object or map. So let me call the author service dot create dot create dot. So this is a cascading annotation. I am gonna dot will return to this service. So not on this create, it will call on this the author service. So I'm gonna here call the create. So dot dot create author, and I'm gonna pass the author here. So this is will work fine. Let me save, and when you let me to see the result here. If you try to refresh now, and we need to if you try to add, for example, add a new author here, John Doe, and we need to get here bio. We need to get a JSON lorem ipsum. So let me copy this, and inside the emulator here, the John bio, and I'm gonna paste this lorem, and the age will be, for example, 55. When you click add, the author here will be added, but I want to go back and rebuild the app to see the result, or close the app and reopen it. So now John Doe will not appear here. So if you try to rebuild the app, it will appear. So if you try to rebuild the app, the John Doe will be, yes, this is a John Doe. If you open also the Postman, you can see this new author. So to make it auto refresh, so let me go here. Yes, let me test also and close this, and get all authors. Get all authors and click get, and you will see the last one. If you go to the last one, you will see here the author name is John Doe. So this is work fine, and also we have the Postgres QL. If you go to this Postgres QL and if you edit all rows, you will see also the last author inside this table will be John Doe. If you try to make it bigger, so and this, so this last one is John Doe. So this is work fine. Let me go to the VS Code, and here I'm gonna mark this. So after add this user, I'm gonna go back to the list view using the navigator dot pop, and inside this, inside the home, when you call the push, I am gonna mark this message as async and await the result, await the result to come back. And after the result come back, I'm gonna rebuild the rebuild this using the, I'm gonna rebuild this, rebuild this widget. So this widget using the set state. So here I'm gonna set state, and inside the state I'm gonna use the author response equal to author service dot get all authors. Let me save now and retry. So here I'm gonna, so the last one is John Doe, so let me add another one, for example Khan, and the bio here Khan bio. And I'm gonna add new paste, and the age will be 55. Click add, it will be return back, and here the result will be Khan. So you can also show snack bar here. After this, you can go to this and create another here in the home, create for example final home key, so equal global state, so global key of scaffold state. So and I'm gonna assign this home key to the scaffold. So inside the scaffold the key will be the home key, and I'm gonna use this home key to show snack bar. So the home key dot current state, so dot show snack bar. Here it will be, I'm gonna use an object of snack bar. Snack bar, the content will be your, for example you can use any text here. Text, I'm gonna write for example your author has been added successfully. You can put any message. Let me save this and try to add a new one. So let me click add, and my last author, the bio here, my last author bio, and add another lorem ipsum here, paste, and the age for example 24, click add. We will get back and your author has been added successfully. And when you go to the last one here, the my last author. So this is the end of this lecture. In the next lecture or the incoming lecture, I'm going to talk about how to delete an author from the database or from the server using the Chopper package. Please don't forget to share, subscribe and leave a comment. See you in the next lecture.